Farsi class. Today, it's time for some grammar lesson. Okay, it's not that difficult in Farsi. Alright, today I'm going to teach you how to form present perfect verbs in Farsi. It's really easy. If you already know your past tense verbs, forming a present perfect tense verb in Farsi will not be that difficult for you. Why? Because in Farsi, in reality, the present perfect tense is connected to the past tense. Those of you who don't even know what a present perfect tense is, I'm going to give you an example in English. In English, we use verbs such as, I have seen that film, or I have gone there. These are examples of present perfect tenses. Well, what does it mean? In reality, a present perfect verb refers to an action which has started in the past, but the effect is still valid for the present moment. For example, if you say, I have turned on the light, it means that you have flipped the switch quite a while ago, but there is still light in the room. So, remember this example. It's very useful. Now, how do we say, I have gone? In Farsi. Okay, we have to start by focusing on the simple past tense in Farsi. If you remember from one of the previous videos I made, when we want to form a verb like I went, we will focus on the stem, raft, and then we will add am to it. So I went would be raftam. Very good. Now, how do we say I have gone? Very easy. All you need to do is to add e right before your ending, which means you will have to break the verb raftam into raft and am, and you're going to put e right before am. So it would be rafteam. Same applies to all other persons. For example, if you want to say you have gone, again you will start by focusing on the past tense of you went. You went rafti. Let's break it into the stem and the ending. Rafti. Now let's put a right before the ending. Rafte. Now, with the third person singular, it can get a little tricky. He or she has gone. How do we say he or she went? If you remember, it was simply raft. Nothing is being added to the stem of the verb. So, in this case, all you need to do is just to add e, rafte, and that's it. Nothing else is necessary. For the plurals, we have gone rafteim, you plural have gone raftein, and they have gone. Rafte'an. If you don't know what's going on here, you will have to go back and check the previous videos that I have made about verbs and verb tenses. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. Make sure that you're going to rewatch this video, okay? So, leave your comments for me in order for me to know how to proceed with making the future videos. And please do not forget to like the video or dislike it if you don't like it. Share and subscribe. I would appreciate it. Thank you. Merci. And until the next lesson, khodafez.